Malassezia is a genus of yeasts that are commonly found on the skin of warm-blooded animals, including humans. Some species of Malassezia can cause skin conditions such as dandruff and seborrheic dermatitis, but others are considered to be part of the normal skin flora. The exact role of Malassezia in skin health is still being studied and understood. In this video, we will explain the trigger factor, symptoms, diagnosis, treatment options, and prevention of Malassezia. By the way, welcome to our YouTube channel. Please don't forget to thumb up and subscribe. What skin conditions are associated with Malassezia? Malassezia yeast can be associated with several skin conditions, including dandruff. Malassezia yeast can cause overgrowth on the scalp, leading to flaking and itching of the skin. Seborrheic dermatitis. This is a common skin condition that causes red, scaly patches, particularly on the face and scalp. Pityriasis versicolor. A condition in which the yeast overgrows and causes discoloration of the skin, often on the chest and back. Folliculitis. Inflammation of hair follicles that can be caused by an overgrowth of Malassezia yeast. It's important to note that not all cases of these skin conditions are caused by Malassezia, and that other factors, such as genetics and environment, can also play a role. Additionally, Malassezia yeast is often found on healthy skin and does not always cause skin problems. Trigger factor of Malassezia. There are several factors that can trigger an overgrowth of Malassezia yeast on the skin, including increased oil production. Malassezia yeast feed on the oils produced by the skin, and an increase in oil production can provide more food for the yeast to grow and proliferate. Hormonal changes. Hormonal changes, such as those that occur during puberty, pregnancy, and menopause, can increase oil production on the skin and trigger an overgrowth of Malassezia yeast. Weather conditions. Warm, humid weather can create a favorable environment for the growth and proliferation of Malassezia yeast. Stress. Stress can disrupt the balance of bacteria on the skin, leading to an overgrowth of Malassezia yeast. Certain medical conditions. Certain medical conditions, such as Parkinson's disease, HIV or AIDS, and organ transplantation, can weaken the immune system and increase the risk of skin conditions associated with Malassezia yeast overgrowth. Use of certain medications. The use of certain medications, such as antibiotics, can disrupt the balance of bacteria on the skin and increase the likelihood of an overgrowth of Malassezia yeast. It's important to note that these triggers do not guarantee that an overgrowth of Malassezia yeast will occur, and that other factors, such as genetics and environment, can also play a role. Additionally, the exact role of these triggers in skin health is still being studied and understood. How are skin conditions associated with Malassezia diagnosed? Skin conditions associated with Malassezia yeast are typically diagnosed through a combination of physical examination and laboratory testing. Physical examination. A dermatologist will usually perform a visual examination of the affected area to assess the symptoms, such as redness, scaling, and flaking. Laboratory testing, if needed, a skin scraping or sample of the affected area may be taken for laboratory analysis. The sample can be examined under a microscope to identify the presence of Malassezia yeast and rule out other potential causes of the skin condition. In some cases, a fungal culture may be performed to confirm the diagnosis and identify the specific species of Malassezia yeast involved. It is important to seek a medical professional's advice if you suspect you have a skin condition associated with Malassezia yeast, as proper diagnosis and treatment are important for managing the condition. Predisposing factors to Malassezia proliferation. There are several factors that can increase the likelihood of Malassezia yeast overgrowth and proliferation, including warm, humid environments. Malassezia yeast thrive in warm, moist environments, which can increase the likelihood of overgrowth on the skin. Oily skin. People with oily skin tend to have higher levels of sebum, which is a preferred food source for Malassezia yeast. Immune system suppression. People with weakened immune systems may be more susceptible to skin conditions caused by Malassezia yeast overgrowth. Antibiotic use. Antibiotics can disrupt the balance of bacteria on the skin and allow for overgrowth of Malassezia yeast. Skin injuries or irritation. Skin injuries or irritations can create an environment that is favorable for the growth and proliferation of Malassezia yeast. Certain medical conditions. Certain medical conditions such as Parkinson's disease, HIV or AIDS, and organ transplantation can also increase the risk of skin conditions associated with Malassezia yeast overgrowth. It's important to note that these factors can increase the likelihood of Malassezia yeast overgrowth, but do not necessarily guarantee that a skin condition will develop. Additionally, the exact role of these factors in skin health is still being studied and understood. How to treat Malassezia? Treatment of skin conditions associated with Malassezia yeast typically involves the use of antifungal medications. The specific treatment plan will depend on the severity and type of skin condition, as well as the patient's overall health and medical history. Topical antifungal medications. Topical antifungals, such as ketoconazole, miconazole, or clotrimazole, can be applied directly to the affected skin to treat mild to moderate cases of dandruff, seborrheic dermatitis, and pityriasis versicolor. Oral antifungal medications. For more severe cases, or for treatment of systemic infections, oral antifungal medications, such as terbinafine or itraconazole, may be prescribed. Lifestyle changes. In some cases, changes to the patient's lifestyle and skincare routine may also be recommended. For example, reducing the use of oily hair and skin products, and avoiding triggers that can cause skin irritation, such as harsh soaps or detergents. It is important to follow the specific treatment plan recommended by a healthcare professional, and to seek medical attention if symptoms persist or worsen. Self-treating skin conditions can result in further complications, and it is important to receive a proper diagnosis and treatment plan. Thanks for watching, please take care and stay safe.